welcome back. And if you tuned in late, my special guest is Celia Beauchamp. Now, she is a certified diabetes educator. But what we're talking about today affects all of us, whether we have diabetes or not. And she brought along this, which is kind of nice, and the portion size. Now, some restaurants are getting smart, and they can offer, and you can check, there are restaurants who do that, a smaller portion and charge you less. And many times, the plate is so loaded down, you can't eat it anyway. And so you waste the food.
We call it portion distortion, and it's something that's happened over quite a lifetime. I know in mine, when I was a child, we could get a Coca-Cola in a 6-ounce bottle. Now the typical size is a 20-ounce bottle. But as time has gone on, we've increased our portion sizes, and that's increased our calories. And for people with diabetes, it's increased the amount of carbohydrates and sugars that they eat as well.
So there's no real way to determine if you're going to get diabetes or how to avoid it. It isn't like going in a room where somebody has measles and you know you're going to get the measles. It doesn't work that way.
Well, like I said, there are some risk factors that increase your risk for having diabetes. So in certain families where diabetes is already present, and you know that there are people there, certainly in my family, we have a long history of diabetes, so okay. I know that I'm at risk, even though I don't have diabetes yet. But I do eat like I could have diabetes because I know that that's a good possibility.
But if we all adopted some of these things into our everyday habit of eating, more fruits and vegetables, a little smaller portion size, not so many colas and that sort of thing, we could help.
Yes, we could help prevent or delay the onset of diabetes. And for some people, they manage their diabetes just with diet. That is a possibility. So let's look at this plate a little bit. This is called Plan Your Portions. This is from the American Diabetes Association.
Okay.
And what you'll notice about this is that it starts with a 9-inch plate. So a 9-inch plate might not be something that everybody has in their kitchen, but you might want to see if you do. Sometimes it may look like a salad plate at your house.
So a little smaller plate.
Smaller plate. Start with a smaller plate because we all eat with our eyes, so we want to start with something smaller. You're going to take half of your plate and cover it up with your non-starchy vegetables. So those are things like green beans and carrots, broccoli, asparagus, okra, tomatoes. Everything you can make a salad out of would be those non-starchy vegetables. And fill up half of your plate with those. These are very low in carbohydrates. They don't turn to a lot of sugar through the process of digestion. So that's a good place to start. Then about a quarter of your plate, you want to fill up with what we call starchy vegetables. Your starchy vegetables do turn to sugar, and we all need some sugar because sugar is the fuel for our body. So about a quarter of your plate. I normally say it's about the size of your fist, or if you have a measuring cup, you'll notice that it's about equivalent to about a cup.
And that can be rice or potatoes or...
Correct. It could be
macaroni, corn.
All of those kinds of things. Anything that's starchy. These also have fiber in them, so that's an important part of keeping your digestive tract working well, so we want to make sure that we eat some things that have a little bit of fiber in them. And then a quarter of your plate, we want to fill up with something like lean meats, so that would be turkey, chicken, roast beef, pork. It could also be fish, and the American Heart Association recommends that we have 2 to 3 servings of fish, oily fish each week to help with our heart health. So this would be a great way if you're trying to think about what can I do. What's one thing that I can do to get maybe my diet back into a place that needs to be?
And even if you don't have diabetes and you want to lose a little weight, this kind of eating is helpful.
Absolutely, because remember, we're portioning these a little bit more. We're using a 9-inch plate, so we're not using a platter to eat off of. We're not using one of these great big dinner plates that we fill up because we eat until the food's gone on our plate typically.
And so many restaurants give a big portion. And I said something one time to somebody who owned a restaurant, and they said, if we cut the portion, people complain.
Well, I think some of it has to do with how much we're paying for that too. So I think if some of the restaurants, and some do, will cut the portion and cut the price, I think people would be a lot more willing to try smaller portions.
Well, that's something to think about. And there are some restaurants that are doing that now, and maybe more will get on the ball and do it.
I think so. I think it's a trend that we're seeing, that people realize that overeating is not good for their diabetes or their heart disease, or a lot of the chronic diseases that we see are because of overweight, and we really need to look at that.
Okay, so sports drinks, normal portions. Not all sports drinks are filled with sugar, are they?
No, some of them are reduced sugar. But if you do have diabetes, you do need to read the label, because again, a portion size is important. So typically a portion size for beverages, unless it's listed on the label as something else, is 8 ounces. 8 ounces, which is 1 cup. This is 1 cup. So I brought a sports drink here today. I wanted to show, This is a 32 ounce bottle, and there are 13 teaspoons of sugar in this whole bottle of sports drink.
And so we go to the grocery and buy that. We don't realize that.
Correct. That is right. So, and you may have some children, maybe they're associated with a sports program, and they may be drinking a lot of sports drink. So just being aware that...
All right, so how do you avoid this? When you go to the grocery to buy whatever, how do you avoid it?
Well, one of the things that I like for people to think about is how much water are we drinking? Because water is a good hydrator. Not everybody needs a sports drink.
Okay.
Not everybody needs a sports drink. So remember that sports drinks also have sodium in them. So if you have high blood pressure, drinking a lot of sports drink may not be something that you need to do. Also, some of the sports drinks contain potassium. So if you're already taking a potassium supplement, that also may be something that you need to discuss with your physician to make sure that you're not getting more potassium or sodium than you need from a sports drink.
And it's never too late to learn and to adjust your eating habits.
Never.
If you've eaten a certain way for years, it doesn't mean you can't change.
It doesn't mean you can't change, but remember, if you've been eating for a long time, if you've been eating for 60 years, changing your eating habits is not something that will happen overnight. It does take some planning, and it does take, I call it, it's a journey rather than a destination. So sometimes it takes you a little bit longer to get where you need to get when you're changing behaviors, but it can be done. And I've seen a lot of people who've done it.
So the main thing is to listen to somebody like my guest and start thinking about what you're really putting into your body.
That's correct.
And of course, right, we have good fruits and vegetables available. The roadside stands, the farmer's market, you can save money, and the fresher, the better.
Well, and also, too, a lot of people say, well, eating healthy is expensive. So let's talk about that just a minute, because sometimes that is true. But one of the things I want people to understand is if you will eat fruits and vegetables in season, they're less expensive. You also can choose frozen vegetables and fruits. Typically, they don't have any salt or sugar added, with a few exceptions. And you can also get canned vegetables that have no salt and sugar added.
So read the labels. We have
some options available to us. Learning to read a label is a great thing, because it's going to help you find that there are a lot more choices that you can afford than you think.
So now, if starting from scratch with a family, some of the simple things that a family can do, including the children. Mm-hmm. Well, we have a few minutes. Give us some ideas.
Okay. Well, I think one of the things is to try to prepare as much food from home as you can.
Okay.
And I know that's difficult for a lot of families because
yes,
they're working.
Yes, it is.
But trying to maybe do some preparation on the weekends, where you have some leftovers that you can eat throughout the week. coming up with a plan and involving all the family members. Family members are much more likely to participate in meal planning if they feel like that they've had some input into it, making lists of things that you like and you don't like. And some nights maybe buying a meat that's already prepared from the grocery store, but then adding some frozen or canned vegetables that you can put together really quickly. Also having some healthy snacks available. So having fresh fruit, maybe have some of the little mini carrots or the little small cherry or grape tomatoes with either hummus or some low-fat ranch dressing, offering those to your children rather than chips always and candy and cookies. So teaching them what are some healthy snacks, but more than anything else is mothers and fathers need to role model good, healthy eating in front of their children. They learn how to eat from us. So if we're not eating healthy, then they're not going to either.
Yeah, and I think we need to watch when we go out to eat what we order. And I'm amazed at sometimes the portion size. But some people in the restaurant business have said, well, if we cut the portion size, people start complaining. Mm-hmm.
Well, I think a lot more people are being more mindful of how much they eat, and so they may even appreciate it more than we realize.
Yeah. So there are lots of things we can do, and Celia, of course, has all the answers. But you're a diabetes educator. But the information that you give out is for everybody.
Right. And one thing I do want to mention is that Greenville Health Systems has a number of programs both for pre-diabetes and for diabetes. And if people will give us a call, our number is 455-4003, and our diabetes program can refer you either to the diabetes programs or the pre-diabetes programs. Some are free, some are paid for partially or in full by insurance coverage or Medicare. Right. So if you do need some education, if you feel like there's some help that maybe we can give you, please feel free to give us a call and we'll be able to refer you for education.
And I'll keep the information here if you didn't get it and you want it. We'd be glad to share it with you. Thank you, Celia, for sharing your knowledge with us. Life-saving information, that's what I call it.
Thank you for having me. I appreciate it.
And wherever you are, get out those fruits and vegetables and put some apples out on the table for your kids. We'll all be better off. Stay happy, stay healthy. We'll see you next time.